Hello viewers, welcome to my channel. I'm Hasham Ali Khan. So in this video, I'm going to explain you the theory of the chapter material in the subject cost accounting. So in examination, most often a theory question will be asked regarding the importance of material control. What are the different techniques available? What are the records to be kept for controlling the inventory? The different techniques of controlling the inventory like stock levels, EOQ, then different ABC technique, VED technique, JIT technique. Apart from that, what are the methods of pricing the material issues? So many different topics are there in material. So a student must be aware, must know how, what we have to write regarding this control of material. So already on this topic, a number of problems I have solved. So if you want the problems, you have to go to the playlist, select the subject cost accounting, material topic, and you can get many problems on material. But right now I'm focusing only on theoretical aspect. Come on, I'm beginning with the meaning of the term material. So material means the commodities or substances which are used in the factory for converting it into raw material. Material constitutes a major substantial portion of the total cost. Therefore, utmost care should be taken so that the metal should not be wasted. There should not be any loss of material. So utmost care should be taken because the major portion of the total cost constitutes material in many manufacturing organizations. The material means the substance or commodities which are used in the factory for converting it into finished goods. There is the terms inventory, material, stores are sometimes used synonymously, but there is difference between these three terms: material, stores, inventory. Material means only the commodities, only the substance which are used for converting raw material into finished goods. Stores is a wide term which includes material apart from that sundry, supplies or tools or jigs. All these things will come under stores. And inventory. Inventory includes not only stock of material but also stock of work in progress, stock of finished goods. All these constitutes inventory. So this is the meaning of the term material. Now I'm going to discuss you about the types of material. Broadly, we divide the material into two types: direct material, indirect material. The direct material are those material which are specifically purchased for making that job, for completing that order, for that particular process. So specific material purchased for a particular job, order, process, activity, that is called direct material. Direct material. Example, in case of furniture manufacturing, the wood is the direct material. In case of cloth making, the main cloth. In dress making, the main cloth is the raw material. Similarly, in case of many other industries, the main item which is used in the production, that is called direct material. Now, indirect material are those material which are not specifically purchased for a particular product, but a material which is commonly used in all the products. So this type of material which are commonly used in all the products, not specifically purchased for a particular product, is called indirect material. Example, nails in case of furniture manufacturers, thread in case of dressmaking, and glue, fevicol in case of binding works, etc. So these are called indirect material because the material is not specifically purchased for a particular commodity. Then we come to the next topic, storekeeping department, its need and importance. Storekeeping department is that department which is concerned with physical storage of material. Actually, material will be purchased in advance in anticipation of production. So before production takes place, material has to be purchased and kept it safely in a department. That department is called stores department. The responsibility of stores department is to safeguard, to take utmost care of the material from the time it is received till the time it is consumed. So stores department is that department which receives the material after inspection. First of all, material will be procured by the purchasing department. It will be sent to the inspection department. Once if it is verified, inspected, it will be sent to the stores department. The person who is in charge of the stores department is storekeeper. And storekeeper has to take the responsibility of safeguarding and keeping safely the material till the time it is required in production department for converting it into finished goods. So the need is very important, because without stores department, it will be difficult to keep the material, to keep safely the material. And importance, it is very, very important. Without stores department, the material cost will increase, because there are chances that material will be, lost, will be lost by theft, pilferage, deteriorated, and misplaced. All these things will arise if there is no stores department. So every manufacturing company has to keep a stores department to keep physical storage of all the material. Now, storekeeping records. See, whatever material is received and how much material is consumed, the movement of material should be recorded. So proper records have to be kept for recording all the movement of material. When the material is received, how much the material is received, how much is issued, what price to be charged for material. For all these things, record keeping is necessary. So for material record keeping, two types of records are kept. That is bin card and stores ledger. So both are the records which are concerned with movement of material. First of all, bin card. Bin card is a card which is hanged on the rack of the material, where the material is kept. All the material are kept in racks in the stores department. The rack is a particular area where the material is kept. So over that rack, one card will be hanged. On that card, we write down the material name, material code, then maximum stock level, minimum level, reordering level, average stock level. All the details of that material will be recorded on that card. And on that bin card, we will have three columns: receipts column, issues column, and balance column. The only quantity will be recorded in bin card, not the price, not the value, only quantity. The storekeeper is responsible for maintaining this bin card. He will record whenever material is received, he will record whenever material is issued, and after every receipt and issue, a balance is stuck. So always we can be able to know how much balance of each type of material we are having. So this is the bin card, which is kept in the stores department and recorded, maintained by the storekeeper. One more ledger is there, one more record is there for movement of material, that is stores ledger. This stores ledger is also similar to bin card, but this stores ledger will be maintained by the cost accounting department. The cost accountant will maintain this stores ledger. It will also have all the details of the material regarding the name of the material, the code, maximum level, minimum level, all the details will be recorded. Apart from that, the receipts, issues, and balance column, we record the quantity, rate, and amount. That means we will have not only quantity, but also value of that material will be recorded in stores ledger. So this stores ledger will be maintained by the cost accounting department, whereas bin card will be maintained by the storekeeper. Now, very frequently in examination, theory question will be asked, what are the differences between bin card and stores ledger? There are similarities as well as differences. Both are the records kept for recording the material. The purpose of the keeping bin card and stores ledger is same. That means we want to record the movement of the material. And we want to find out what is the value of the, what is the stock of material kept on a particular date. So the main difference is, the bin card will be maintained by storekeeper, stores ledger will be maintained by the cost accountant. In bin card, we record only quantity, whereas in stores ledger, we record quantity as well as value. Similarly, some transactions are there which will be recorded in stores ledger, but will not be recorded in bin card. like material transfer from one job to another job. That will be recorded in stores ledger, but will not be recorded in BIN card. So some differences are there between stores ledger and BIN card. Now, inventory control, its objectives and essential of inventory control. Inventory control is a very wide term. It includes all the systematic control system which is maintained from the date of procurement of material to storage of material to consumption of material. So different stages are there for material usage. First of all, when material is needed, the material will be procured by the purchasing department. The purchasing department will purchase the material and it will be sent to the inspection department. The inspection department will check the material whether it is of the right quality, right quantity or not. If it is that material which we have ordered and the material is not defective material, then it will pass on the material to the stores department. The stores department will keep the material till the time it is required by the production department. Whenever a requisition for material is received from production department, the storekeeper will issue the department for the usage. So first procured, then stored, then used. In all these stages, the material should be controlled. The purpose of inventory control is the investment in material should be minimum. There should not be any interruption in the supply of material. Material should be supplied as and when it is required in the production department. There should not be overstocking of material, nor there should be shortage of material. So there should be coordination among all the departments. That means purchase department, inspection department, stores department and production department. All the departments which are concerned with material, there should be cooperation, there should be coordination. There should be some specific procedure how to procure the material, how to store the material, when the material has to be issued. Everything should be standardized, and the recording should be timely made in the BIN card as well as stores ledger. So number of steps are required for inventory control. The main purpose is to reduce the cost of investment in material. That's it. Now, techniques of material control. There are different techniques available for controlling the material, controlling the inventory. The perpetual inventory system. Perpetual inventory system means a system in which a balance is struck after every receipt and issue. So in BIN card as well as stores ledger, we open three columns: receipts column, issues column and balance column. Whenever material is received, it will be recorded in the receipts column and then balance will be calculated. Similarly, whenever material is issued to the production department, after every issue, balance will be calculated. So this system of finding out the balance after every receipt and issue, that system is called perpetual inventory system. There are many advantages of perpetual inventory system. The first advantage is always at any time we can be able to find out what is the quantity of material on hand, what is the value of material on hand without physical stock taking. Without physical stock taking, we can have on hand the quantity and value of material. That is the main advantage. Similarly, we can be able to keep a track on the movement of material. All these are the advantages of perpetual inventory system. Now, stock levels. Another method of controlling the inventory, technique of controlling the inventory is stock levels. The storekeeper is responsible for the movement of stock. He has to be aware when the stock has to be replenished and when the stock should not be further purchased. So always the storekeeper has to keep an eye on the movement of every item of material. So for that purpose, stock levels will be fixed. So on the BIN card, the different levels are fixed for every type of material. What is the maximum stock level? What is the minimum stock level? What is the reordering level? What is the average stock level? What is the danger stock level? So all these details will be written on the BIN card. So every day the storekeeper has to check that stock in order to control the material. So what are the stock levels? Minimum stock level. Minimum stock level is that level below which the inventory should not be allowed to fall. Always the material should be above the minimum. So what is the formula for calculating minimum stock level? Reordering level minus normal usage into normal reorder period. Similarly, maximum stock level. It is that level over which the inventory should not be allowed to go. If the inventory goes over maximum level, that means there is overstocking of material. When there is overstocking of material, that means the loss due to interest on investment that will arise. That means more amount is invested in inventory. The business will lose the interest charges. So reordering level. It is that level, whenever inventory reaches this level, a new order should be placed by the storekeeper to the purchase department. So reordering level is that level at which a new order will be placed for replenishment of the stock. And the formula for reorder level, maximum usage into maximum reorder period. Average stock level. The average stock level is between maximum level and minimum level. The formula for average stock level is minimum stock level plus half of reorder quantity. Danger stock level. This danger stock level is below the minimum stock level. If the inventory reaches the danger stock level, the storekeeper should take emergency action to replenish the stock. Because if the material is not purchased even after reaching this danger level, that means at any time the production will be stopped. There will be interruption in production, leading to huge losses. So what is the formula for danger level? Average rate of usage into emergency delivery time. So these are the different stock levels. This technique will be applied to control the inventory. Next comes economic ordering quantity. Economic ordering quantity is that quantity at which the carrying cost and ordering cost will be minimum. So two types of inventory cost are there, carrying cost and ordering cost. Carrying cost are the cost incurred to store the material in the godown. Jitna zyada material godown mein rahega, utna carrying cost zyada hoga. And ordering cost, the cost incurred to place the order and receive the goods. So if we frequently make orders, our ordering cost will be high, but carrying cost will be less because we are keeping less quantity in the stores. Frequently we are placing the order. Similarly, if we purchase the quantity in bulk, if we purchase the material in bulk, what will happen? Orders will be less, ordering cost will be less, but carrying cost will be more. So there is inverse relationship between ordering cost and carrying cost. If you want to control ordering cost, carrying cost will increase. If you want to control carrying cost, ordering cost will increase. So there should be some balance between these two, ordering cost and carrying cost. So EOQ, economic ordering quantity, is a technique to find out how much quantity of material to be ordered in one place, at one time. At a time, how much quantity of units, how many units of material should be ordered, so that ordering cost and carrying cost both are minimum. So what is the formula for EOQ? 2CO by I under root. Where C stands for annual consumption, O stands for ordering cost per order, I stands for carrying cost per unit per annum. By applying this formula, we can get how many units we have to place the order in order to reduce the carrying cost and ordering cost. The next thing is, next technique is ABC analysis. ABC analysis is a selective method of controlling the inventory. Selective method means equal control will not be applied on all the items of inventory. If we closely watch the actual practical store situation of many manufacturing organizations, we can see that there is a small items of inventories whose value is very high. So according to one of the study, it says 5 to 10% of items are there in the whole inventory. Those 5 to 10% of items have 75 to 80% of value. The value 75 to 80% of all the inventory, whereas the quantity is only 5 to 10%. That means less quantity, high value. We categorize it as A items. So A category items are those items whose quantity is less, but the value is very high. Similarly, B category. Some items of materials are there whose value is between 10 to 25%. between 20 to 25%. The value is 20 to 25%, whereas the quantity is 15 to 20%. That means the quantity and value more or less are similar, approximately similar. We categorize it as B category items. Now C category items are those items whose quantity is huge but the value is very small. Approximately 70 to 75% of items are there, but whose value is ranges only 5 to 10%. The value is only 5 to 10%. So less value, more quantity. So this will be categorized as C category items. So according to ABC analysis, all the inventory items should be categorized into A, B, C. A category items, more value, less quantity. Strict control should be applied on A category items. B category items, moderate items, neither high nor low. So medium control will be applied on B category item. C category items are quantity more, but the value is less. Least control will be applied on C category item. In this way, selectively we are applying the control on A, B, C. That is one of the technique. That's why it is called ABC analysis. Very frequently in examination, theory questions will be asked regarding ABC. Now JIT, just in time. Some organization will not keep inventory at all. They will think that by keeping inventory, our money will be blocked. We have to pay more interest charges unnecessarily. Why to keep the inventory, so high inventory? They will purchase the stock whenever it is needed. Whenever it is needed. That means, for example, a car manufacturing company. The car manufacturing company will not purchase all the items of the cars at a time, because the car manufacturer knows when we need which type of material. So whenever that type of material is required, only at that time we purchase the material. We will not keep huge material in the godown. In this way, the investment inventory will get reduced, because we are purchasing the material whenever it is required. We are not keeping unnecessary stock. That is called just in time. Next, VED, vital, essential and desirable. In the case of ABC analysis, we have classified according to value. Whereas in VED analysis, we are classifying according to their criticality. According to the criticality. So V, vital. Vital items are those inventory items which are very critical. Even if there is a shortage of these vital items for a single day, huge loss will be incurred. So business cannot afford so much of loss on this item. So strict control will be applied on vital items. Essential items are also necessary, but the loss due to non-availability of these essential items will not be as much as the vital items. So essential items are there, but the loss will be not very much. So these will be categorized as essential items. Desirable items. The desirable items are those items whose criticality is very low. Even if it is not available for 2-3 days, the loss will not be much. So these will be called desirable items. In this way, according to criticality, all the inventory items will be classified into VED, vital, essential, desirable. Strict control on vital items, moderate control on essential items, and least control on desirable items. That's it. Last one, FSN analysis. Fast, slow, normal. Fast, slow, and normal. The fast, that means movement. How fast the material is moving. If the material is required very fast, the consumption is very fast, we categorize it as F. S means those items which are slow moving items, and N stands for normal moving items. So according to speed or frequency of movement, we classify the inventory into FSN analysis. That's it. Now the last topic in this material is pricing of issue of material. See here, material are purchased at different time, at different prices. The prices of material are not same always. Always the prices used to fluctuate. Normally it will increase due to inflation. The material prices will increase. The storekeeper will receive the material on different dates at different prices. So whatever material we are having in the godown are of different prices. Now the question will arise, whenever material is required in the factory for consumption, for producing the job, for making the products. We have to charge the material cost. Now the question arises, which material cost we should apply? Because we have purchased at different period of time, different prices. Now we have different methods of pricing the material issues. First method, FIFO, first in, first out method. The material which is received first should be issued first. So whatever is the actual price, at the actual price only we will charge the material. First in, first out. It's a very simple method, easily understandable method, easy to calculate, and the actual price will be charged, and the closing stock will reflect the current prices in the market. But the difficulty in FIFO is every time, whenever new material is purchased, we have to calculate the we have to record all the material. So more clerical work is required in case of FIFO method. Next one is LIFO, last in, first out. This is opposite of FIFO method. Last in, first out, the material which is lastly received will be issued first. That means whatever closing stock we are having, that closing stock will be the old stock, the fresh stock purchased, and it is issued. Again, it's very simple, easy to calculate, easy to record it, but the difficulty is clerical work will be more, because more recording we have to make. And next one is average cost method. The first two methods says every stock should be kept separate. But average stock, cost method says all the stock should be mixed up. We calculate the average cost, and that average cost will be charged for the material consumed. The average are of two types, simple average and weighted average. In simple average, simply we add up all the prices divided by number of prices. For example, three times we have purchased at 5 rupees, at 6 rupees, at 7 rupees. So we add up 5 plus 6 plus 7 divided by 3. We'll get the simple average price. Whereas weighted average, we multiply the price with quantity to get value. Price rate into quantity, you'll get the value. Take the total value divided by total quantity, you will get the weighted average price. At weighted average price, we charge the material. And comparatively, weighted price is more appropriate. Then comes base stock method. In base stock method, a minimum stock will be kept separate, only to be used during emergency. Only during emergency that base stock will be used. Till that time, the base stock will not be touched, because some critical material is there. If there is a loss of material, then the huge loss will be incurred. So separately, some minimum stock will be kept. Then specific price method. Under the specific price method, specifically the price are fixed for every lot. Now, whenever material is issued, we will see what is the price of that lot. Accordingly, that lot only will be charged. That means we are not concerned with first in or last out. That is, we are not concerned. Specifically, whatever price is there, the same price will be charged. Next comes market price or replacement price. Some organizations will charge the material at the replacement price. What is the replacement price if we purchase now? Then standard price. The management will fix a standard price. That means when material are consumed, we are not concerned at what price we have purchased. But the management has fixed a standard price. At that standard price, we charge the material. Last one is inflated price method. In this method, in some cases, there will be loss of material. That means due to storage, due to spoilage, some material will get lost. So the loss will be charged for the remaining good material. The material price should get inflated. The material price will be inflated. We have purchased 100 tons, 100 kilograms. Out of 100 kilograms, 2 kilograms are lost. So we are having only 8 kilograms. So the loss of two kilograms will be charged to the remaining 8 kilograms and inflate the price. Now material will be charged at an inflated price. So this is the complete theory regarding material. So if you are satisfied with my lecture, give a like to the video. Share it in your friends, among your friends. And lastly, don't forget to subscribe my channel.